all know, na, behave with maturity. Otherwise, you become like school children. Okay. So, you all can see the shape, right? Correct? This is our drawing of a ship. Now what happens is, flags are sensitive issue. That means they must be seen from a distance. One of the reason is seen from the distance because flags are also used as codes to pass the messages. So they should be seen from a distance. So that is what it controls is, the size of the flag, what we use normally, are about 2. Huh? Huh? What happened? What happened? Okay, never mind. We'll see afterwards. Okay. Fine, let us see afterwards. Now I'm not going to allow you to unmute, okay? Okay. Now, let us get back to the topic. So the flag size on ships, normally the flags are approximately little over 2 meters. We used to use 6 feet by 4 feet. Equivalent one will be like just over 2 meters by about 1.2 meters, 1.3 meters. So that is the standard size of the flag. Another thing is flags. On one rope, you can have multiple flags on a single rope. Means one is on top, separated by tack line, another flag. That is the combination of flags. How many flags we are supposed to have on the ships? 26 alphabets. 26 alphabets. 10 numerical flags. That is 0 to 9. 3 substitutes. These are for signaling, which are covered by International Code of Signals. In addition, you have got, if company has got a specific flag, which is called jack flag, you may have that. That is a smaller size flag. Then you will have country's flags. Now, normally what happens, we know where we are going, generally. Okay, we go to these countries. So we have their flags. Then you will also have something called ensign flag, which will be a flag where the ship is registered. It may be a national flag or it may be ensign type. Ensign type means we will come to that later on. But those are the flags which are used by certain countries to differentiate between their ships. And in armed forces, in Navy, they generally have these ensign flags to indicate who is on board and all. They have got more codes in that, but that is something that beyond our syllabus. And it is complex. You will need somebody from Navy who can explain you their ensigns. Now, we know there are flags. So we have got a bunch of flags. There is a particular way of rolling the flags. Rolling means making a small thing like a small roll and store it. Storing, we affectionately call it pigeonholes. Pigeonhole means there is a big box with cavities and there it is marked A, B, C, D, E, F and then national flags and all. So they are kept there. Ships generally carry 2 sets, generally, but a national flag may be a single one. Depending on, because flags are expensive, and sometimes what happens is, if you have not ordered flag on time, the normally the third officer looks after it. The if he has not ordered flag, because when we are planning the voyage, we say that okay, we are going to go from here to Chile. Fine. Now the third mate is going to check. Normally, chief officer will tell him to check you have a chili flag or no. So if you don't have chili flag, for example, on board, and you're going to land up in a chili, then you need to get it with pilot and all, and it's more complex, and that times the typical bill may be flag $50, transportation $200. So this is what happens. So we are very careful on checking our flags. Then every alphabet and all, you have got at least two sets. Then sometimes there are some common ones which are used, like one is Bravo, because that is with the dangerous cargoes. Then you have got a golf and hotel pilot flags, quarantine flag Q. These are the main flags which are used. So you have sometimes additional set because the wear and tear is more on these flags. Where do we hoist them? Now we know that it should be seen from a distance, because that will identify whatever ship is saying without using VHF set. And at times, you cannot see clearly VHF sets. You know, you cannot hear clearly. A lot of disturbance is there. But then the pilot boats or harbor boats, they can identify your ship at times looking at your flags. Like we also use medical flag in certain ports so that the boat knows which ship is asking for medical help. Instead of searching for ships' names, you may not be able to read ships' names at a distance. Anyway, coming back to where do we fly them? Highest mast. Now, remember, highest mast can be anywhere depending on type of ships. Earlier days, we had different types of mast. The ship was not like this. Hatch covers were there, but accommodation was sometimes here. But, you know, where officers had accommodation here, then the crew had accommodation aft. In between, we had masts. One mast, second mast, maybe a third mast here. Why you needed mast? Not for sailing, but masts were used as a support for cargo loading discharging system like derricks, which are like booms. Okay. Today, you may not see the ships with derricks because they're labor incentive. Means, whatever happens, you need a lot of people to rig up derricks. Now, when I joined Sea Life, my ship had derricks. We had five holds, and we had number one had two derricks, two had four derricks, three had four derricks, four had four derricks, five also had four derricks. So what used to happen was that was to maximize loading discharging capacity. Now each set was supported by a mast. In between, we also had over number two and number three hatch, we had some jumbo derricks, and number four also had. Those were special derricks. They needed more rigging up and all, and then they were used for carrying a special heavy lift. Now, those days, heavy lift was, according to definition of the company, it was anything over 5 tons. Now, you will laugh at it, because today, when we say 5 tons, we don't even think as a load. But anyway, those days, it was the case. So, we had different sets of masts. So, just imagine, if for example, if I put it here, okay, just assume, okay, this ship is different now. One mast is here. Another one is here. Maybe the third one is here. So these were masts, and the derricks were attached something like this. You know, they were stored and all, but the derricks were like this. And these derricks had something to do with it and come down the ropes and all. Like, they were tied up at the end of it, and then the wire ropes used to run down on winches and all. Now, the problem which was there with this was system for a cargo perfectly okay, but the highest mast was not on the bridge. Bridge was also lower. Sometimes the bridge was somewhere here, and that height was something like this only. They were not tall like today's ships. They were quite squatted, you know. Now here, even if we had a small radar mast, it was like this only. So the which was the main mast? Main mast was this. Why? This was the tallest mast. So this was the tallest mast. So this was the main mast. So our flags were flown from here, not from here. Highest mast is the main mast. Plus, we had radio room was here, and we had aerials, which end one end was tied up here, other end was tied up here, sometimes another end was tied up somewhere else, because they were horizontal aerials. So now these systems, what we had to do was every time we went to port, we lowered it to remove it, make sure the mast is clear, the derricks were rigged, and so on. Over the period, what happened was this derrick system disappeared. Derrick system disappeared because so many people are required. My first ship, we were 64 total, captain to brand new cadet like me. We were total 64. Today, in 64, you will man 3 ships. So there is more automation, more convenient arrangement. The cranes are a lot more efficient than the derricks. So things change. So what happened? The main mast, which was used for flying flags and all, disappeared from a standard design. Okay, we'll make it disappear. Disappeared, right? Then what happens? You get a ship like this. Here, this ship may have, for example, cranes, for example. Right? May have crane. Something like this, and a hook here. Possible. But this is not mast. Normally, this will be always taller. You will not see generally a ship's crane is higher than this. Doubtful. So what happens is our tallest mast. Now what happened? The tallest mast automatically came on bridge for two reasons. These masts are not designed for any specific use except very little use, but they are there. The foremast is designed to carry what? To carry forward masted light. So forward masted light is there. There is one whistle on foremast, and that's it. And some antennas, because a lot of antennas need separation or distance-wise. So this is the only one tall spot, so we may put some antenna here like this, whip antennas. And here also on bridge also you have a lot of whip antennas and all across. But now you don't see horizontal antennas anywhere on ships. They're all vertical. They're like a whip, like a rod. So again, what happens is we have got foremast, which is used exclusively for forward masted light and a whistle. And if you are at anchor, you may put a black ball hoisted here. That is a signal in ROR that vessel at anchor should display it in a forepart. So that is where we will put. But its height is less because it has a forward masted light. So you put the height only for that purpose. Forward masted light has to be here, so we make it this tall. Fine. Second masted light is going to come here, correct? That is generally the tallest part of the ship. And this mast, why do we need it? We need this mast for a masted light. We also need to have radar antennas, which are scanners, to be employed somewhere here. You can put it here also, no problem. But somewhere you need to put radar scanners. So if you have got two radar, one will be maybe here, another one will be here, and my satellite will be here. So this mast is also designed basically for this purpose, for the mast light, radar scanners, and Christmas tree lights. Those are all various signal lights, and they are at the highest point. That is why we call it main mast, or you can call it radar mast. But by virtue of being the tallest mast, it becomes main mast and becomes automatic arrangement for flying flag. This is what you have to understand to get rid of all the confusions you will hear about the mast. The our days masts were like foremast, mizzen mast, main mast. There were more names also. Now I have forgotten. Mizzen was behind. So based on that, we had to select where we had to fly flags. Clear? Any doubts on this? Never mind, who is Shefali? We don't know. Okay. Now, somebody contacted me saying that, sorry, I joined by mistake. It was anatomy class, but how will she get identity? I don't know. So somebody is fooling around, right? How will she get that invitation for this? Never mind, mischief. Never mind. That's okay. I'm becoming popular. Outsiders want to attend my class now. Okay. Let's move on. So, we were here. Correct? Main mast, avoid confusions because we have too many names for mast and the mast actually come from sailing ship dates. We are continued. We are not abandoned everything. Okay? We have not abandoned everything, all the old maritime terms. So mast is still mast. Now only the purposes have changed. Sailing ship masts were a strong element because, you know, they needed a single piece of wood. It used to take the load of windage. Like I told you, in Talegaon, suddenly all the leaders have disappeared because their posters, not posters, the billboards, the big ones, they are all torn in tatters. So they could not take that sort of storm wind. But remember, on sailing ships, same winds were taken by main mast and the foremast and mizzen mast. They had a lot of mast because every mast had sails. So it used to be a very strong pillar. I mean, they needed a single piece of wood to that height from the bottom of the ship. Anyway, coming back to our mast. So today what we have got, some mast with a dual use, means something else is used, and some mast where you can use the flags. Why? Because that is the tallest mast, like main mast. So I got only two masts on a ship today, a foremast, main mast. Then if I had to fly flags, all I need is a simple thing, like what? I just need a pole. You can put pole anywhere, like if you are your favorite restaurant nearby. What is that? Maratha Palace, na? Or something? Maratha something, right? So, Royal Maratha, whatever. So, what happens is, there also he has got some poles put there with a small flag. He can hoist and he has got some flags there. I don't know why people put it, but that is a simple method of putting a flag. One flag is put on one pole. We don't use the pole type of stuff except two places. One is jackstaff, where a simple pole is put maybe about 2 meters in height. And another one is ensign staff. Again, this will be maybe 3 meters in height. Jackstaff, now staff means pole. Okay, staff means pole. So, Jack staff, you will get a flag here, which will be Jack flag. That is a company flag, which is the smallest flag. It is just something like maybe 50 centimeters by 35 centimeters, like that size. Some ships had, Shipping Corporation of India had one. So we had to fly that flag also when we were in port. No other flag here. And today, most of the ships, you don't see Jack staff. Why? Because this, in bad weather, this can get smashed up. That's first thing. The next thing is the purpose is over because you don't have Jack flags. So most of the ships won't have it on. If no flag, what is the point in having it? If you don't have basic thing, then why do you need it? You are not going to look for a horseshoe unless you have got a horse. So you don't have a horse, you don't look for a horseshoe, like that. And people used to stand here and give instructions while mooring and all. But after few accidents and snapback zones, that has disappeared. Today the systems are a lot different. Okay, this is the jack staff, where a jack flag is flown. Jack flag is a company flag and a small size. Foremast, we don't fly any flags there. Why? Because it is not our tallest mast. Where is the tallest mast? On top of bridge with a multipurpose use. There are radar scanners, there are signal lights there. And it is, if this is we see from side, it is a T-shaped mast. One flag, two flag, maybe three flags here. You can fly like this. They all will be tied down somewhere here, where you can stand and make fast with figure of 8 knots. I mean, this also will be tied down here. This also will be like that. So it is on a T shape. And additionally, this one also has got a small shendi. You know what is shendi, no? Triatic stay. There is, this is shendi, means the one which is here. That is the way to remember it. This place is reserved for ensign flag. When ship is moving in the water, it is a reserved place. When ship goes to anchorage or port, we put it here. So this is the last job which is done when ship comes in port, and that is what generally cadet and AB will be closing the bridge, or cadet goes or baby is closed, whatever it is. Who is the last person? He ensures this flag is removed from here. All other flags are flying properly. Closes doors, locks them up, everything, brings this flag and hoists here. Ensign staff. Next. Okay. So, this purpose is clear, reserved one. Another reserved spot, the starboard side. This is the starboard side, okay? I'm looking from behind at the main mast. This is the main mast. This is what I'm looking at. Starboard most halyard is used for courtesy flag. That is that country's flag. Wherever you are visiting, the most sensitive flag is this one. For not flying a flag there, you can be in a serious trouble. That is, or not flying it properly also. The fine minimum, nobody talks less than $10,000 in any case. But there will be imprisonment with it because everybody takes flag very seriously. And especially country flags. You know, every country has got their own history where thousands have died to keep that flag flying. Every country had got history. Means whether it's India, USA, China, anyone. So, very sensitive issue in every port. You have to be very, very careful of the way you fly this flag. This flag, you have a problem, not that big issue, but this is the most sensitive flag. this flag, ensign flag, that country may not see, but in case you are going to have a flag state inspection or something, then you can run into problem. But ensign flag also is a serious, but this is the most sensitive issue. So we know where we fly the flags, correct? Additional flags like a pilot flag, golf. I can fly here. I had to show change the golf into hotel. Why? Because now pilot is on board. Golf said what? I require a pilot. Hotel says I have a pilot on board. So that golf is removed and next flag is put here. Fine. You may have a quarantine flag here that my vessel is healthy, request free fatigue. Depend. Nowadays, flag use has come down because everything is done via messages. So we move on to the next slide now, because this is just to warm you up. Now we get more serious. What happened? Okay. This is how you will see the ship from front normally. Okay, the portholes. See, this is a specially reserved place for captains. It will be like this, half will be captains. You can see everything what you are doing from top. Okay. Typical ship, older ships, you have got a wheel house here, and these are the bridge wings. What you see here are the wind deflectors. So when you stand here, you can still keep your eyes open and see in front. If you stand here, you may not be able to keep your eyes open in wind. On average, the ships have got speed of about 35 kilometers per hour or more on average. Okay. Anything between 30 and 40, take a normal ship. To make matters worse, this is ship speed. You have got a wind opposite you, which is adding another 35 kilometers. What you have got? 70 kilometers per hour speed wind here. Then you cannot keep your eyes open. Same thing trying to ride motorcycle and reaching the speed, then you can't keep eyes open. So this is why there are wind deflectors here, this side. Okay, coming back to our point. Mast, radar scanner is here. These are those whip antennas, what I said about the antennas, the vertical. So these are the ones. And then you have normally a T-shape. Now here it is, this is funnel. This is the mast. The flags will come from here. Okay. What you will see is, I'm drawing little big flag, but flag will be like this tied up. Okay, this side also. Now, see, I can't do it with the touchpad so well, like flags. This is how you will see from the front. And this will be, if outermost flag, this will be courtesy flag. Okay, so this is how you will see from front. Now, don't worry, ship designs are old, everything is fine. This is where you have got side lights, extreme ends, port side light, starboard side light. If you had a mast here, you would have seen a masthead light here, forward masthead light, and second masthead light here. And then you will have this red light here, green light here. You remember, Aroha, both the masthead lights will be above the side lights. Always remember that. So this is how you will see the ship. That is, at night time you will see masthead lights and all. And daytime, if you are approaching port, that time you will find the flags flying. Then you will see something like this tied up here. Maybe another flag flying here. They all are tied at the, because there's only one base where you can tie it up. Okay, clear here. Let's move to our next slide. This is one ship. You can see the flags flying. Now, obviously, what this guy is doing is he's saluting the ship. So he has lowered this flag down. This flag is indicating I require a pilot. This is ensign flag. Now, also remember one thing. Liberia is a country where large number of ships are registered. Liberian flag is very identical to US flag except the stars. Stars are different. There is one star, I think. I forgot now. So now you see again, scanner is here. The satellite dish antenna is above this. And flags are flown from the base point. And also they have got this daylight signals. This daylight signal is what? Restricted in ability to maneuver. Now the ship may be doing something. I don't know. This is more like a tug type of ship, you know, means it is special purpose one. These are whip antennas. What we call, see, these are the this different ones are antennas. There are a lot of stuff on board, you know, we need lots of antennas. So these are the single ones like a rod. It is like whip only. Next one. If you see from, now this is seen from the aft. This picture is taken from the aft. And it is obviously not a typical merchant ship. It is one of those pleasure yachts or something, you know. With the big ones, no, very rich people have them. Okay, there is one question. Why most of the ships register in Liberia? Because Liberia, Panama, Bahamas and all, those are what tax-saving places. That means your ship obviously belongs to somebody registered in Liberia, so you can hide your identity and you pay lesser taxes. Basically, you pay lesser taxes in Liberia, Panama, and so-called flag of convenience. Most of the shipping, as I understand, things are, a lot of American money is there, large amount. And Liberia was formed, means the Americans purchased land in Africa and formed Liberia. The reason was to, what to do with the slaves they had imported from Africa. So they bought the land and rehabilitated those slaves in Liberia. And it is run, most of the time Liberia is run by some strong man. They get coups and all. That's it. Okay, coming to our point. This is seen from behind. There are lights. Here you can see signal lights. Then there are different whip antennas. This is another type of antenna. Here got horizontal one also. But see the fact, halyard. This is halyard. No, Jatin, it's not enough for the day. These are the halyards. 1, 2, 3, they have got place to tie, they tie there. But starboardmost position is reserved for the specific flag that is that country's flag. They are in US waters, so they are flying American flag. This side, this yellow is quarantine flag, my vessel is healthy, request free pratik, and some other flag which I can't identify from here. This PPT, I think, was shared. Okay, Vivek, it was shared from the shared files. I'll check it again. If you don't find it, then I will again put it back to the, because I think I put it in shared folder. Okay, so this is how it looks. Now, don't worry about these flags, okay, because this is ashore. They ashore, they do a lot of stuff. But idea is to show you how multiple flags are flown. Multiple flags are shown on single halyard. Like first flag separated by tack line, second flag separated by tack line, third flag. So these three flags can be sending a message. Here there are four flags. Now this combination, here also there's fourth one, sorry I missed it. But this is a code. That means it says these are the combinations and this is the meaning. That you need a code book. And naval ships, this is what was done between the ships. They used to pass the messages by flags. And there used to be a person who used to be in charge. He was also known as a Bunting. Bunting was this flags. And material of flag is also known as Bunting. Ensign is also rank in Navy and ensign is also flag. So there are a lot of naval terms which do mix you up a bit. Okay, so this is how you fly multiple flags separated by a tack line. This is how a typical flag will be. This is the flag hook. The reason we use flag hooks will come down later on another slide. Width of the flag, height of the flag. The part which is close to this rope is hoist half. This half part is hoist. This is called fly. Normal width ratio, width to height ratio is 3:2. Then here, there is a rope which may be about 1.5 meters, 1.2 meters, where there is no rule on that. That is tack line. These are the simple parts you should be able to put it down. Normally the question will be there. Now, this is how a flag will look like when you have got this rope. I have shown you the rope also, the one which is continuous length of rope covers flag plus tack line. The one end of the rope is here and it is spliced actually, or not spliced, it's tied up in a special way to a flag hook on top. This rope continues full length. That means if this is 1.2 and this is 1.3, no problem. 2.5 meters length of the rope. Before you put this hook, you have got a sleeve. There is a white sleeve on which the flag is stitched. So this, you slide it inside. Then you can do this lower flag hook. This one is stitched along with the rope so that the flag doesn't move up and down or slide on the rope. This is how a flag is made. Now this is whole thing flag, what you store in your lockers. You fold it, then you use the same rope to wrap it up. And on this white sleeve, generally with a marking pen, it is written what flag it is. So what happens is when you take out a flag, you just pull it out, read it. Okay, it's written Q. Okay, it's Quebec. Fine. Open it, hoist it. So it becomes easier. It's possible once in a while somebody may make a mistake, so you always check. Because finally, if you are going to hoist the flag, it is your responsibility that you are hoisting the correct flag. Rarely you will find this sort of a mistake, but I have seen it once. These are flag hooks. One is a flat one and one is swivel. The top hook is this type, flat one. And it is attached to a swivel hook. One swivel hook will be there, means what we are looking at it is like this. This is tied to the upper end of the halyard, which goes over the sheave, goes down. Okay? And this part is hooked on to this. This is a rope, which is we use as a halyard to hoist and lower. In between here, what we will have, the flag has got this hook. So this one, the fixed type, comes here, locks it. This will be inverted anyway. That will come and attach here. So what happened, the combination, the halyard will have swivel attached to the flat hook of the flag. The lower end of the flag on the tack line is a swivel hook it is upside down. That is attached to the halyard. So when there is no flag, these two ends are locked with each other and this is tied up because there is no flag to fly. And this will be at the bottom. And when you hoist the flag, what you do is you open that knot, then you hook up the top end of the flag, lower end of the flag, and you hoist, pull on this rope. So the flag will go up and start flying from the top. Is it clear? So purpose is what, tackline? Tackline's purpose is to separate multiple flags on single halyard, because from a distance, if you are flying two flags, I should be able to read both the flags clearly with the binoculars or without binoculars, but normally you will need binoculars in today's range is like that. So tackline is to separate the flags. Flag hooks, what is the purpose? Easier and faster arrangement to check flag, change flags while signaling. Now the signaling affair, it doesn't go on merchant ships. Ujjwal, I know we have done this before, but we are going through again for simple reason. We are revising just to ensure that you all don't forget before exam. Okay. So this signaling, it can be played as a competition and all, just to have get used to it. But today the importance of flags has come down drastically with other modes of communication. Otherwise, flags were mode of communication. That factor has changed today. Now, different locations of the flags on the ship. At hoist, this is a normal flying position, top of the halyard. That is normal. If you lower it by about 2 meters, means to indicate it is not on top, it is little below. Half mast doesn't mean necessarily 50% you measure or something. It is below. This is national mourning, means some prime minister, presidents and all die, or sometimes some very important person dies who has contributed lot for the country. Then we display our mourning by putting it on what we say half mast, but it is not exact. It may be 3/4 in height. So most of the times you are here 99%, 1% time possible you have to lower it. Now all flags are not lowered. Okay. All flags are flown at this topmost position, perfectly fine. Half mast is not for your Quebec flag or a pilot flag or something. Half mast is only for national flag. Mourning period, national flag is sort of brought down. Dip is a temporary position while saluting. Means what happens is, suppose there are two ships, okay, and this is a naval ship. I'll try to draw here naval ship, okay. This is flag there, okay, naval ship's flag. What you will do is, if you are to salute, you will bring down this flag here and wait. It is like I put hand here for saluting and hold it. This one, moment they see you are saluting, they will bring it down somewhere here. And they will pick it up again. That means what they will do, they will also do like this and lower hand. When they have lowered their hand, means taken the flag up, then you pick up your flag and bring it back to normal. This is the etiquette for saluting. Okay, this one we have already covered. Courtesy flag, that is visiting country's flag, has to be the starboard most. That is the best position we give them that importance. All other flags can be anywhere. Once you put this one there, normally you will obviously try to put one, two flags here only. If you need more, then you occupy. No problem. But starboard most one is courtesy flag. Ensign flag will be flown here while moving. I told you there is a little shandy there. This is the shandy on the mainmast. So ensign flag will be flying from here. That means it will fly like this. Right, when you are moving, once you reach the port at anchorage, this flag has to be brought down. Remove the flag from here and put it on ensign staff. So again, going back to the first part. Company flag, jack flag here on jack staff, all other flags on mainmast, and ensign flag right up. Simple on a modern ship. These are ensigns. Like these are the British ensigns. Red ensign, normally the red flag with the quarter flag will be the flag. It's, India also adopts the same thing, is merchant navy. Then your white one, that is government owned ships, and blue one was used by Navy. In addition to that, you have all these symbols and all, and these marks have got some significance in armed forces. Okay, so it is outside our syllabus, but in case you are curious, contact one of the persons from Navy and armed forces. They will explain you how these meanings are, because they have got their own history. Next, the end. This is what you all wanted for some time. So now, anybody has got any questions? Ask, put it on chat. Moyuk, any doubts? Who's sleeping? Jatin, Laksharaj, Manish, Mihir, anybody doubts? No, no one is studying now. No doubts. Very good. Then we can call it off. Correct? And ensure that now, I don't know, new timetable should be coming. But you continue taking our tests without fear. Because I want you to become the best of the best of the best of the best. Aur bhi do chal dal dena. Okay? End of the meeting. Shefali, we'll see afterwards who is Shefali.